looking at your health as an entrepreneur can be quite daunting, right? You've got all these businesses going on, business transactions, business relationships, networking events. It's kind of easy to push your health to the side. And before you know it, everything breaks down. Before you know it, you've put on 10, 20, 30 pounds. Before you know it, you're beyond the point of no return. So what do you actually do? When you realize that your wealth is suffering, your health is suffering, your relationships are suffering, you're not having as much sex as you used to, purely because you've lost confidence. Your body has changed. Your energy levels have changed. Your whole entire lifestyle has changed because you're a victim of your own success. When I work with a client, as an individual, on a one-to-one basis, we like to make sure we get to the root cause of these things. What happens with your relationship with food? And we all have one. We all have a certain relationship with food. Some people may binge out when they go through a lot of stress. Some people may simply just reach for a peanut butter jar. Some people may go and grab a tub of jelly and chuck it with the peanut butter on some white bread. Some people just go and get the candy. Some people just like the savory stuff. Some people will just not eat, causing more stress to go onto their body. All of these things are rooted deep into our subconscious mind. And we may not even know the trigger until we dive into it. And this is where my coaching differs to any other coach I've ever noticed or seen or spoken to within the fitness industry. Because, yes, I could give you a meal plan. Yes, I could tell you exactly how to train. And yes, we do sort these things out. Not necessarily a meal plan, but we build up the habits to make sure you know how to eat at home, from takeouts, at restaurants, on masterminds, on business trips, in hotels, in gas stations, wherever you may be. I do the research. Only yesterday I was speaking to a client who's just gone on a trip, last minute. Ollie, can you find a gym here? Cool, found a gym, he's training today. But if we can't find a gym, we've got hotel workouts, we've got bodyweight workouts, we've got things you can do to make sure you do not fall off your goals. But the big thing is that my revitalization blueprint dives into the stories you tell yourself. There's always a link between our history and our present moment and where we want to be in the future. There's always going to be some small or big subconscious belief that we need to find that trigger and we need to step back and disconnect that with our present state. It may be, for example, myself. You know the story about my dad dying when I was 15. Before that, we used to get on a Saturday night when I was able to see him at the weekends. We'd watch a program here in the UK which covers the soccer coverage on a Saturday called Match of the Day. The theme tune would come on and it was kind of like a trigger. Because we'd eat loads of chips, we'd eat loads of candy, we'd have loads of chocolate. And it was comforting. I was there with my dad, my hero. I was watching my favourite sport and I was eating comfort foods all around my nan's house. And if you guys have a nan like I had before she passed away, you would know that there was never a shortage of food. It was there in copious amounts and you couldn't say no to that lady. It was, do you want a cake? Do you want some sponge? Do you want some crisps? Do you want some chips? Have it. You sure you don't want it? Go on, have a little bit, just a little bit. A little bit won't hurt. And these things were deep ingrained into my subconscious mind. So Saturday came. Saturday would always be the day I'd seem to fall off. And it seems the way with a lot of entrepreneurs. One reason is that the structure is there Monday to Friday, and then Saturday, Sunday, we kind of get overwhelmed because we haven't got the structure in our schedule. We're there with the family and kind of with that a deer in the headlights. We get stalled and you think, what do I do? What do I do? What do I do? And you need to have some structure built into it. But the good thing is that it's easy to sort. Once we speak, once we connect, my superpower is connecting with you guys. It's connecting with entrepreneurs, successful entrepreneurs like yourself, to go back, to find where these triggers have begun. To develop a plan from that specifically for you. Specifically for you as an individual, your schedule, your needs, your desires, your goals, your life. So if you want to talk about your history, you want to talk about your story, you want to talk about moving forward, you're tired of starting. Well, let me tell you this. If you stop stopping, you can stop starting. Think about that one. And when you're ready, drop me a message. Either on a DM, hit contact on the website, or just go to ollie@revitalizationblueprint.com and send me an email. I so look forward to talking to you guys. We shall speak soon.